morning, boys and girls. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Keeping in with the tradition of earlier years, St. Joseph's College has once again organized this incredible annual fest. And the motion for discussion today at the English debate is an extremely poignant one. Morality is the creation of the weak to tether and limit the strong. At the outset, I'd like to thank the principal and management of my alma mater for extending this privilege to me to be a part of you all at this event. Friends, I'm sure all of you are just as I am, eagerly waiting to hear the budding youth, this young generation, speak their hearts out for and against a motion which I feel, according to me, holds the key to radically changing the way in which individuals and maybe the human race is going to perceive the world in the years to come. I really won't say India, but the youth in India in 2017 is definitely younger, confident, and rising. So ladies and gentlemen, this is what we are going to see. In a vibrant India, are the answers different today to a question of universal importance? I had thought I would run through the rules, but I guess that's already been done.
Before starting with the debate, I would like to request the team managers of the participating schools to escort the participating teams of the group creativity competition to the Hogan Hall at 3 p.m.
Was he a man with high moral values? Because yes, he ended up being in jail for the crimes he committed. So we cannot say that a person who is strong and wealthy, who has all the luxuries of life, is happy, has moral values. Because yes, that does not matter, ladies and gentlemen. Quoting F. Scott Fitzgerald here, he said, "If you are strong, there are no precedents." Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say that instead of working on money, instead of working for money, to gain money and to gain success and popularity and power, ladies and gentlemen, let us work on our moral values. Because yes, a person with high moral values is respected, and I have to say that a person with high moral values is successful in my eyes, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you and have a nice day.
2 minutes and 47 seconds. Any interjections? Please introduce yourself. Keep the question short and crisp.
Hello. Good afternoon. I'm Yashasvi Raj. I've been speaking to you the example of Ram Rahim. How does the example of one person is applicable to the entire race of rich people at large? Please justify.
Okay, my opponent here has raised a really good question, and I would love to answer your question. See, from the beginning itself, we are taught that moral values are the things which we need and which take us forward. So I think that Ram Rahim, not only Ram Rahim, there are many cases which we have heard.
Please specify.
Good morning everyone present here. Today I'm here to speak against the motion. Morality is the creation of the weak to deter and limit the strong. With more than one point on my side, I say no to the question. Morality is not respectability. We need to understand this. Morality does not earn us respect. We are respected when we are strong. We live in the 21st century. Today, moral values have lost their meaning. People are known for their strength, their capabilities. We generally say that morality is beneficial in the long run of our good life. But we do not know what God has planned for us. I'm there with you today. I might not be there tomorrow. In the words of borrowing, I would like to say, she once said, "I have not been asking God to give me good morals or make my life easy, but I have been asking God to give me strength to bear all my weaknesses and to understand all my pains so that my life may be easy." I have an example. Mukesh Ambani. We all know of him. Mukesh Ambani is one of the richest citizens of India. More than 90% of the Indian population wants to be like him. We take his struggles and all the work he has done in this field as inspiration. But when do we talk about his morals? What his moralistic behavior was? There might be many other good and equal capable people with him in the same field, but his strength through all the struggles made him strong. I have one more example. I once took part in the inter-house debate of my school. The teacher gave us the topics before the time as per the rules, and I had actually seen that topic behind one of my library books which I had concerned for the particular debate topic. I went and told my teacher. She said, she praised for me for my honesty, and then she told me that she will change the topic. Later, one of my classmates who had heard the topic before, much before the time, he knew about the topic, but he did not tell. He kept his strength and capabilities. And I, because of my moralistic behavior, lost the match and he won it. This story speaks much of it. I rest my case.
Judges, please note, 3 minutes and 4 seconds. Boys and girls, those speaking for the motion will be interjected by those speaking against the motion and vice versa. Yes, introduce yourself.
Good morning, I'm Sita Tiwari, and my question to you is that you talked about Mukesh Ambani, who has the lineage of billionaires. What about those people who stuck in their morality but never able to come out and show themselves as shining stars like Mukesh Ambani?
Because they didn't have that strength. That is what my answer is for the question. They didn't have that strength and their morality kept them back.
Yeah, exactly. Morality kept them back.
Yes.
This is Ishan Srivastav, and I want to ask that you said, I don't want morality, I wish for a good life. So what are you saying, that morality can't give you a good life?
When did I say I don't want morality?
You quoted someone, you said that I don't wish morality.
Time's up, sorry. Participants, please note, those speaking for the motion will come on this side of the dais. Those speaking against the motion will speak from this side. 1 minute is to the interjection, and if time permits, at best a maximum of 2 interjections. Coming up next, MPVM School, Allahabad. For the motion, this side.
Morality has been used by people all over the world. Has been used by weak people all over the world as a defense mechanism to save themselves when they see that their defeat is certain. The Lord of Sea used it when Lord Ram threatened to draw him up. The Allies used it when Hitler used better weapons in the Second World War. And I'm very sorry to say, India also used it when they were defeated hugely in the Indo-China War. Now this trait of our ancestors has gone deep into our roots. We are also of the same kind. We lecture our friend whenever he is using some unethical ways solely for his own benefit. On the other hand, when his unethical ways are also helping us succeed, we are the ones that are most enthusiastic. And we are also very crafty in our ways sometimes. Let me give you a small example. Whenever we meet someone who has better command in English than us, we feel, what is there to be proud of in speaking better English? English is the language of the people who tortured us for 1.5 centuries. On the other hand, when we see someone whose English is in tatters, we feel, oh my God, how is he going to succeed? In this world, where speaking English is the most important language. Now this shows the dual behavior of ourselves, and this shows that all of us, not just some of us, all of us are using this mechanism to save ourselves. Now whenever we see some, let me give you an example of a football team, that is Real Madrid. They are also everywhere criticized for their foul play and that they injure the other players. But
I'm going to tell you that they have won the last two Champions League and I think that they're going to win the next one too. Now, these are some of the things that are used by people as a defense mechanism. Now, the question that arises is, who are the people who use morality as a defense mechanism? These people are the weak people. These people are the quitters. These people who don't have any willpower and they are ready to lose, but they're never ready to learn from their competitors. They're never ready to learn what to do better, what to do something good next time so that we win. Now, but all they do is make excuses and excuses and excuses. Thank you.
That was spot on. 3 minutes and 1 second. You have to be there for the invitation, please. Yeah. You are Ishan Shivastan, right? Yes?
I'm Rishabh Narayan Singh from the Boys High School. How can you say India used morality as a weapon against China in the 1962 war?
Do you know the story about the...
Yes, I know very well. That's why I'm asking the question.
Let him answer.
Thank you. Now, in the 1962 war, India was defeated because Indian soldiers were actually fooled by the Chinese soldiers. They said, "Hindi chini, bhai bhai," and we accepted, yes, there are brothers, now let's go and hug them. Are you seriously saying that in a war, we should trust the opposition soldiers if they're saying that they are brothers? They killed us all, we lost. That's the truth.
Okay, fine.
So are you quitting?
Beg your pardon?
You said that morality is used by quitters. So if my morals tell me that thievery is wrong, so I'm quitting, right?
No, I said it is used by people who quit. It is used by people who don't have willpower. It is used by people who don't realize the situation, what do we have to do and what do we not have to do. So I'm not just saying that only quitters, there are other people too.
Thank you.
Words, with his virtues and his morality, countrymen. Morals are like the a nation's morality is like a tooth. The more decayed it is, the more hard it is to touch them. Sorry. That's it.
Judges, please vote. That is 2 minutes and 9 seconds. Yes, somebody who's not done it before. I think you've done it. You haven't. There you are. Introduce yourself.
Respected madam, you just mentioned about beggars, that if beggars are given money or any job opportunities, they will not align and they will do something immoral. Do you have any statistics or facts to prove that point?
Yes, it has been proved. I have my personal experience.
Personal experiences don't count into statistics.
But I am a person and what is more truthful than my own personal experience than relying on
something?
Hello.